Hey everyone, and welcome back to our channel. As you can see, it's just me.
It's okay, babe, I'm right here.
Well, yeah, Michael's behind the camera, right? But he thought this video would be best, just me and it. But yeah,
more personal feel for you, babe.
I guess you can say this video is a tell of my pregnancy, where, how I've come along so far, what I've been going through, what my thoughts have been, and I just want to break it down a little. And today I enter my third trimester, which is kind of crazy, but I'm excited because I get to meet this little boy in just 3 months. So looking forward to that. In the beginning, I never thought, just kidding. Okay, so yeah, anyways, let me take it back to the very beginning. So as soon as I knew Michael was graduating from law school, I wanted a family. Long ago. If it was up to me, I'd probably have 4 kids by now. But I mean, here I am, my first baby. But anyways, as soon as we found out Michael had passed his classes and was graduating, I knew I wanted to start a family, and we started trying. Now, I knew when we started trying, I didn't think I was gonna get pregnant right off the bat, you know, because I've been reading so much, I was doing research, and a lot of the times, it could take a woman anywhere from 6 months to a year, but I got pregnant in the first try. But anyways, I kind of knew I was pregnant prior, well not prior to that, but my body was already giving me like signals. I remember we went to the movies and I was kind of leaning on Michael and he was eating chocolate and I was like, oh my gosh, like get that smell away from me. It was a smell I couldn't really stand. From that day on, I just started marking all my symptoms of what I was feeling. I was fatigued, tired, and June 30th came and I couldn't go based off my period, as in, you know, you're late, you're pregnant, because I am TMI, but I'm irregular. So I do not get my period every month or, you know, the way some girls are spot on. So June 30th came and I told Michael, okay, we bought the pregnancy test. We were in San Antonio, took my test right before Michael took his big test. And it came
literally like an hour before I started the bar exam.
Our lives were gonna change forever.
It was 6:30 in the morning. And you know, I'm getting ready to go to the first day of the bar exam and she's there doing that. And then from there on, go to take a bid.
Well, from there we got our big fat positive and my heart just kind of dropped. You know, honestly, I thought I was gonna cry tears of joy, but it was kind of just like, I was just shocked. You know, it's kind of like, wait, what? Is this real life? But anyways, the first 8 weeks, I want to say, because I couldn't go to the doctor till I was, or 6 weeks. Wait, do you remember how long before I went to the doctor? Was it 8 weeks or 6 weeks when I found?
It was 6 weeks.
Okay, so
yeah, 6 weeks.
So 6 weeks. You know, I didn't want to say anything because my fear was there's always miscarriages or you just never know, you know. And I wanted to hear that heartbeat before I even said anything. So that was one of the hardest secrets to keep. But in the back of my head, it was constant fear. And Michael kept telling me, he's like, don't worry, you're stressing not just yourself, but you're stressing the baby. The baby was like, teeny. You know what I mean? But I was putting that stress on him already. But anyways, when we went to the doctor and I finally got. And what's even scarier is when we were at the doctor, they told Michael not to record because, you know, the possibility of miscarriage and this and that. So, of course, I was nervous, but...
Not only that, just the, yeah, it's miscarriage, right? But the fact of not getting a heartbeat.
Yeah,
right? When you're doing the ultrasound, it was kind of surreal because it's like, really, like, they have to prep you. You know,
yeah.
Because, and it seems like they see it, not often, but it happens.
It
because
happens.
For them to tell you that...
It's something that's
happened before.
Yeah.
you know, you have parents that are happy to start recording and you don't even get a heartbeat.
Yeah, so thank God we did get our heartbeat. We saw it. And even then our doctor told us like, okay, yes, you know, there's a heartbeat, but you can't get too excited because you're still so early in the pregnancy, you know? So it was so hard for me to be happy because her words were constantly in the back of my head. You know, I did stop working out early on because, well, prior to me getting pregnant, I was constantly at the gym, you know, and so I had to cut that off, and me and Mike would just walk around every day. We started off 2 miles, 3 miles, and up to this day we still walk, but that was my way of staying active for the baby and for myself.
Good healthy activity.
Yeah, so my symptoms in the beginning, I wasn't throwing up, you know, right away. It wasn't till like, I guess, midway of my first trimester when I started feeling like, oh my gosh, the tiredness, exhaustion, the nausea. Oh my gosh, that was the worst. But anyways, leading up to my 13-week appointment, they had asked if we wanted to do the genetic testing, the gender, you know, and me, I was all for it. You know, I wanted to make sure my baby was healthy.
Exactly, because the whole point, from what I remember, mm-hmm. of the genetic testing was more or less, it was actually to find out how your baby's doing health-wise. You know, whether
right.
they have any sort of, I don't know, health
anything.
Setback, anything of that
yeah,
nature.
Yeah, they did. There was several tests.
And the finding out the gender was just a bonus.
The plus, yeah.
And they asked us if we wanted that.
Yeah, so when we found out, I actually found out when I had just turned 13 weeks, I believe, because I did the testing, I'm sorry, I think when I was 11 weeks, I did the whole blood and all that. So when we found out it was a boy, I still didn't want to say anything because, you know, I've heard stories where my doctor told me it was this through the blood and then the ultrasound said it was a girl or whatever. So I was like, nope, I'm not gonna announce until I see my ultrasound and confirm that it is for sure a boy. So that day came and it was a boy. And I've always wanted a boy first. I just thought I was gonna have girls, you know, but.
Team boy.
Yeah, we got our baby boy. Anyways. So my first trimester, I didn't see much of a difference. My body kind of stayed the same. I mean, I did gain a little bit of weight, but it wasn't like, oh, she's pregnant. You couldn't tell. You know, it wasn't when I started entering my second trimester when my bump started forming. I started seeing more changes in my body. And let me tell you, that was probably one of the hardest things for me, and still is up to date, if I'm being honest. I guess I was so used to seeing my body, my figure, a certain way for so long that when I started seeing all these changes, my clothes starting to feel like tight on me. It just looked awkward, you know? And at the same time, I'm happy that I'm growing because my baby is growing too, but it's just hard. So that's just a constant battle that I've been fighting with. And Michael talks to me and has to talk to me and remind me, you know, like, hey, it's gonna be okay. But anyways, my second trimester has been honestly like the best. I have so much energy, I'm up. I do see my belly growing, but I'm good. And now as I enter the third trimester, it's just insane how the first and the second, what was that? Like 6 months just flew. It flew. I honestly can't even believe it.
Yeah, I did.
These next 3 months, we're just getting ready. You know, I'm starting the nest, which is a real thing. You just want to start cleaning and, you know, you're worried, where is your baby going to go? You know, and this and that. So I'm already like preparing myself. We started like his little room already where we started cleaning out, taking all their stuff out. It's just so exhausting, but we'll get there. And me and Michael have also gone, I guess, not shopping, but we already started looking into cribs. And let me tell you, it's overwhelming. Everything I like is like for little girls. But I mean, I'm just trying to find like balance. Also on my free time, I catch myself looking at a lot of YouTube videos of other pregnant women, you know, and I constantly find myself comparing myself and their bumps to my bump. You know, a lot of people are always gonna have their opinions. She's too big, she's too small, she eats too much, she eats nothing. But you know what, it's your journey and whatever makes you feel good, and as long as you're healthy, that's number one. You know, I'm constantly asking my doctor every time I go, hey, am I okay, am I? So she kind of keeps me in place, especially me, that I was like kind of small. I was trying to decrease the chances, or in trying to decrease the chances of cesarean and all that. Just keep doing you. As long as your doctor tells you you're fine in the right track, don't listen to anybody. There's gonna be opinions left and right. In conclusion, over the past 27 weeks, this little baby of mine has shown me that not all bodies, not all women are the same. Everyone has their time and their timeline, you know? And that's perfectly fine. I mean, I've heard it all already. It's crazy. And I've talked to moms, some of my friends that are already parents, doctors, everyone tells you something different. So as long as you're within your comfort, I say just keep doing you. And finally, ta-da! Here's a baby. Can you see ya? There he is. Growing. And he's actually awake right now because I could feel him moving. I think he's actually hungry.
Oh, baby boy.
But I'm probably gonna feed him right now, to be honest.
That's right. Well, what would be your, if somebody watched this far, right? Mm-hmm. Hopefully they did. What would be your ultimate takeaway on whether they want to become pregnant? Okay, let's do first. The takeaway on wanting to become pregnant. Give a simple answer to that one.
You know, you're never ready. But whenever you feel most ready, or go for it. But you honestly, you're never ready.
And I know we've all heard that, and it's sort of cliche, but would you say it's the truth?
It's the truth. Like, I'm so excited, and I honestly cannot wait for this little baby to get here, but at the same time, I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna be a mom. This little life is gonna depend on me, and you know, it's like, hey, wake up. Like, you're the adult. Whoa!
Buddha.
He wants to be with me. Come here, baby. Come make an appearance. Come here. Oh, he's camera shy.
I like that. All right, and takeaway number two, pregnancy itself. Once you've done the deed and you become pregnant, right? Thank God.
It's you know what? Everybody reacts different. So yeah. Far, thank God, so, my pregnancy has been smooth.
So what would be your best advice as to what to expect when expecting?
Expect everything to change. You know, and you're not ready for, you might not be ready for the changes, but they're coming. So just adjust. It's okay, it's not gonna be your whole life. If you're like me, you know how I told you that I've been constantly battling, like with my weight gain and all that. Hey, your baby's only in you for 9 months, and if that's what it takes for your baby to be healthy, do it.
And for you men out there that, you know, do your part in pregnancy.
Yeah, because he's actually a very supportive husband.
Just be the best partner you can be to your wife. They're going through a whole change. Their whole body is changing.
And let them vent.
Yeah, the hardest part is putting yourself in their shoes. Literally, because we can never bear a child, you know, from our body like a woman does. But just remember that she is growing your little person, and she's doing the best she can because this is her first time, as well as for the women. Remember, this is the man's, whether it's first, second, third time, but the first time. Talking for those first parents out there.
this is a man's first time dealing with a pregnant partner. So for both parties, it's just best to be patient. And remember to talk to one another and to really discuss if anything is not working out as far as schedules or regimens that you have in place, and just be open to changing schedules, changing activities, whatever you have to do.
And what's your intake?
My takeaway from it would be that, I guess what I said, just be open-minded. Be open-minded in the sense that everybody's gonna handle it differently. Every woman is gonna handle pregnancy differently and have different expectations, but just be open-minded to change. When you do that, it's easier to anticipate any sort of changes you'd have to make. Mm-hmm.
And how would you rate my pregnancy so far?
I'd rate it a 10 out of 10. I think Dom's, I have nothing to compare it to, but I think she's done very well. She's very understanding with my work schedule. I don't miss any of the doctor's appointments. Thank you.
I was about to say that.
For my boss, you know, works very well with my schedule, and I really appreciate that. And everything's been going very well, and now it's just time for the third trimester.
Yep, and baby shower.
But it's going to be great.
And then
it's going to be great.
Baby will be here in 3 months. It's crazy, like, you know, like, we're going to have a little baby here.
I know, but...
inserts baby.
Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. We appreciate it. Appreciate Dom's little insight on the pregnancy. Maybe we'll update y'all for the coming months until baby gets here.
Because mm-hmm. I heard the
third trimester series.
Yeah, because I heard the third one, your belly just pops. Yeah. You know, so. And I'm just like, whoa. And that's also the
whether we do it weekly or monthly, you'll find out when the videos go up. Mm-hmm. So, but thanks for tuning in, guys. We'll see you later.
Say bye, Buddha. Bye. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my parents' channel. Bye.